Hi, my name is Susan Mingle. I'm a clinical nurse educator with MedOne Group, and I'm here today to do a training session on the Alaris point of care unit and the syringe pump module that you've recently acquired for use. I'd like to start out the demonstration with an overview of what we call the Alaris PCU point of care unit, sometimes referred to as the brain. Nurses like to call it that because without this, nothing else works. So now let's look at some of the features of the point of care unit. The point of care unit's designed much like an ATM machine. You have a very large color screen, and you have arrow keys that surround the screen, and these are going to correspond to a prompt once we turn it on. And you'll notice there's an orange button, that's your silence key, and then below that's your options key, and then over here is system on, which is how you power up the device. And just below this, you'll see your numeric keypad, and notice that the decimal is highlighted with a red circle. On the sides of the PCU, you're going to notice what we call IUI connectors. These are where the modules for the Alaris system attach and reattach at a 45 degree angle. And on the back of the device is where the power cord is attached, and this will power up to four different devices with just the one power cord. There's also what we call our tamper resist button, this black button, that you can press and it will lock out the panel so that you can prevent patients or family members from programming the keypad when you're not in the room. And also there is an embedded ABGN card should you have a wireless connectivity and the Alaris server already in place in your organization. The battery is located beneath, and it's an easy pop out for Biomed, and to replace it, they pop it right back in. As I previously mentioned, these are the IUI connectors, which give the connection for the Alaris modules and the point of care unit ability to communicate with one another. So now we're going to attach the syringe pump module to the point of care unit via the IUI connectors we previously discussed. So what you'll want to do is you want to take the syringe pump module, sort of tilt it at a 45 degree angle, so you're lining up this groove with the actual IUI connector, and then you want to seat it in there, and you'll hear a click when you have reached communication. Now, each of the Alaris modules will have the same buttons, no matter which ones you choose to bring into your organization. They'll have a channel select button, which is how you actually activate that module for use. You have a pause button, should you need to pause the infusion. You have a channel off button when you're ready to discontinue that infusion. And then you also have a restart button, should you have paused something and then you're ready to restart it. Next, we're going to walk through the actual choosing of syringes, loading the syringe pump, and then finally, the demonstration of the drugs on the syringe module. The Alaris syringe pump module accepts multiple vendor syringe sizes from 1 ml up to 60, BD, Monoject, Terumo. The flow rates of the Alaris syringe pump module are as low as 0.01 for your tiny premature babies, all the way up to 999 should you need that. Additionally, the tubing for the Alaris syringe pump module is not proprietary. You can use any tubing that will lure to the end of a syringe and any combination of what your hospital would want to use. So keep that in mind, that it does not have to be a dedicated syringe pump tubing from Alaris. So now we're going to move forward with an instructor-led demonstration. I'm actually going to be walking through scenarios and have a nurse do the actual programming, much like you would do in your own hospital skills lab setting. So we're going to have our nurse take a 10 ml syringe for this scenario, attach an extension set to the syringe, prime the syringe, and then we're going to simulate loading and starting an infusion. So now we're going to walk through an infusion. We're going to start off by powering on the device with the system on button. And we'll wait for the device to go through its diagnostics to confirm via the IUI connector that we have connectivity between the PCU and the syringe pump. And now you'll see one of the first screens that you'll get is this a new patient? And remember those arrow keys that surround the screen. You choose yes. And then we are going to be using a NICU profile for this demonstration. So you will say yes to the NICU profile. Patient ID, we're going to just confirm and skip through that. That depends on if your hospital has that set up or not. And so now it's just going to be in a standstill mode until we're ready to tell it to do something. And how we do that is by using that rectangular blue bar at the bottom of the screen, and it will say select the channel. But first of all, before we select the channel, we're going to actually walk through how you load the syringe. And it's a three-step load. You take the flanges of the syringe and you put them underneath this gray area. Then second, you pull out the plastic barrel clamp and you swing it around so that it hugs the syringe itself. And then lastly, the very top, which is the plunger mechanism, you turn it and lower it down so that it grasps the top of the syringe. So that gives it the capability to press down as the syringe pump is powered on. Now, I'm going to ask the nurse to take the plunger head off and raise it back up to that very upright position. Now, I want to show you a safety feature when you're programming the syringe pump if you don't have it loaded accurately. It will not let you perform an infusion, which is a great safety feature. So I'll ask her to press channel select, and right away you get this bitmap, and it's flashing that she does not have the plunger engaged with the top of the syringe driver. So we're going to go ahead and replace that and get it back down into that position. And once that's confirmed, she presses confirm, and now she's able to move forward with the infusion. So now she'll confirm that that is a BD10 syringe, because it's based on each manufacturer's internal diameter, because they're all different. That's why you have to choose the manufacturer and press confirm. Now we're going to walk through what we call guardrails, which is the name of the safety software. We're going to do an IV fluid. So guardrails IV fluid. And in this scenario, we'll show you the name of the drug is on the left and shortcut keys are on the right, so you can speed through the alphabet. So we're going to choose lipids. So she'll section through the alphabet, the K through O, to get to lipids, and pick L, and then confirm, yes, that's what I wanted. And we're going to start with a rate of 0.1 per hour. And then notice that our volume to be infused says all. You can have that in your configurations default to all, or if she highlights volume to be infused, she could put in an amount that she wants. But for this instance, we're going to go ahead and say all, because we want all the lipids to go in. So we're going to press start. And you'll notice once the start button is pressed, you have the green light at the top, which means that that's a good infusion. Everything's going positive. You have the rate just below. And then scrolling across the marquee, you see the name of the IV fluid, scrolling continuously across. So now we're going to have to power this device off because we only have one for this scenario, but let me show you how you power it off without turning everything off. You press and hold power off till you hear a chirp, then press any button on the keypad. That just at least wipes that infusion away, and now we can go show you how to do a guardrails IV drug. So now we're going to press channel select again. But now we're going to choose the top entry, guardrails drugs. And now here's when your shortcut keys come into good use, because we're going to do midazolam. So she needs to press K through O, then she can hit M, but the drug is there, so we can just press midazolam on the left. And then you have a choice again, based on your hospital's pharmacy guidelines, what drugs will be in here and parameters. For this scenario, we're going to use 2 kilos or greater. And then we're going to choose the 5 milligrams in 25 mils. And then all you do is say, yes, this is what I want. And then you put in your patient's weight, and we're going to say our baby weighs 2.5. And it will remember every other weight-based drug, that weight, should you have multiple infusions that are weight-based. It'll remember that each and every time. So press your next button to confirm. And then we're going to do a dose. So we highlight dose. We're still going to leave the default to all. And then we're going to put in a dose of 10 mics, and it will calculate the rate because it's a rate dose, dose rate calculator. Then we're going to press start. And again, same green light, which means everything's good. The dose is listed below, and the name of the drug and the amount of the drug is scrolling through the marquee. Now I'm going to demonstrate some of the safety software that the guardrails, being a smart pump, will protect you from making a decimal error, too many zeros, that type of programming error. So I'm going to ask Karen to channel select. Then I'm going to ask her to change her dose to 100. She thought she hit 10 and somehow she double key pressed. And so this is what we call an example of a soft limit. It is above the guardrails limit that pharmacy set at 60, but it's giving her the opportunity to say yes or no, do I want to do this? And because she made a typo, she's going to say no, I don't want to do that. Then she can go back and put in the intended dose. Then I want to show you a hard limit. Let's say she thought she put in 11.5 and she hit 115 by mistake. Missed that decimal, press start. This is an example of what we call a hard stop. That means that you cannot go above that limit. You must press reprogram and go back and put in something that's less than what pharmacy has set. Let's go back to our 10 mic dose and press start. So now I've simulated a near end of infusion, which is what will happen when your syringe is close to being empty. I did have to change the drug and the rate so this could happen in a timely manner. So you see green and it's still infusing, but yellow means it's in a pause mode, giving you time to go get your subsequent syringe. So you can go ahead and press the silence button, then go get your subsequent syringe. If you don't bring your subsequent syringe back in time, then it will go to what we call a syringe empty, which just means that the infusion has finished. It's not continuing to run anymore. So this is why we give you this near end of infusion option to set in the configurations. So if you want the heads up, you definitely can program that in. So now we'll just let it go to a syringe empty. So now after the syringe is near end of infusion, if it's not brought back in, and one replaced, it will ultimately go to what we call syringe empty, and you see the red alarm light going. So you want to silence that, bring in your new subsequent syringe, so you can take down the old one. Load your new one with your new 10 mLs, and in this case, we're going to use normal saline. Okay, so we'll channel select. We'll confirm that it's the BD10 again. And then you should see to the left-hand side of the PCU on the bottom button is a restore feature. So if everything that you're programming is the same and the syringe is the same, you hit restore and then you just press start again. So a couple of things to keep in mind on the syringe pump. It has options, so we're going to walk you through a few of those options. So you'll press the blue button that says options below your silence button. And you'll see a couple of things here, display, patient ID, clinician ID, power all, channels down, and anesthesia mode. These are options on the brain or the PCU. So now if you exit out of there and hit channel select on your syringe, now we can look at the syringe pump options. So if you notice that the pressure limit high, notice that. So you have three choices, low, medium, and high to check pressure in the line. Low is 200, medium is 500, high is 800. So let's go back to exit to go back to the main screen and press start. And notice that everything is still running even though we were looking at those options. If you'll notice on the bottom of the syringe, there's a place in there where you could place what we call our pressure sensing disc. This is a tubing that is used for critical drugs on micro preemie babies such as dopamine, dobutamine. And what this does is allow for real-time pressure in the line. So you actually can see what the millimeters of mercury of pressure are in the line when you use that pressure sensing disc. So you'd want to talk to your Med1 rep about getting that tubing in if that's something that your organization decides they would like to do. One additional feature I'd like to show you is if you need to interrupt or delay an infusion to say draw labs or something like that. If you'll press the channel select and press your delay options button on the left. You can actually delay your infusion for hours or until a time during the day. So we're going to choose the delay 4 because we're just drawing some labs, and we're going to put in 10 minutes. And then we're going to press call back because we want to be called back when that 10 minutes is up, and we're going to choose before and after because we want to be notified before and after, and press confirm. So when that 10 minutes is up, we're going to receive an alarm that lets us know the 10 minutes is up, and then all we need to do is go ahead and resume start because we've completed our lab draw. Lastly, we're going to conclude our session with how do you turn the infusion off. But before you do that, you want to make sure that you have charted all the infusions and the volume that has been infused. So if you notice the bottom left button on the brain, PCU, it says volume infused. So this will give you, by pressing that, this will give you all the infusions, whether you had 4 channels running, which is the max that you can have, or just the 1, which we have done in this case. And it gives you the total amount of drug that has infused, the date and the time it was last cleared. So if you're ready to chart, you go ahead and write your numbers down, press the clear all button, and then you can go back to your main screen. But our patient has now been ordered a DC of this fluid, so we're going to go ahead and power down the module. And since there's only 1 module, it will power down the whole system. So you press and hold channel off till you hear a little beep, then you let go. And now you've powered down your syringe infusion. This concludes our syringe pump demonstration. We thank you so very much.